Emma, thanks so much for being with us. I think it's so important when we have these on-the-record statements from women who claim to have been sexually assaulted that we hear from them in their own words. So let me read to you from your article, just so we have this out there. Emma Brown says, while his friend watched, Kavanaugh pinned her to a bed on her back and groped her over her clothes, grinding his body against hers and clumsily attempting to pull off her one-piece bathing suit and the clothing she wore over it. When she tried to scream, he put his hand over her mouth. I thought he might inadvertently kill me, said Ford. He was trying to attack me and remove my clothing. This was the on-the-record statement from Christine Blasey Ford to you. Why did she come forward and tell you this story?
Well, she had decided not to come forward after months of thinking about it. You know, she first came to the Post in early July when Brett Kavanaugh was on the shortlist before he had been announced the nominee. And she really wanted to tell somebody her story, but she also didn't want to have her life upended, and she was terrified of what would happen if she came forward. She struggled with that all summer long. She was weighing that until late August, when she made a very clear decision, I think, that she was not going to move forward. And then things started to change here in Washington. She had written this secret letter, or confidential letter, to Dianne Feinstein, telling her what had happened 30-odd years ago. And news of that letter started to leak. The Intercept wrote about how Dianne Feinstein had a secret letter and Democrats were upset. And then that sort of unspooled, it started just unspooling. The reporters started showing up at her house, at her workplace, calling her colleagues. And she felt like her calculation shifted, because she felt like her privacy was already being invaded. And she still had this thing in her that wanted people to know what had happened to her.
All right, I want to clear a few things up on the timeline, which are fascinating. Number one, she called the Washington Post tip line before Kavanaugh was even the nominee. His name was on the short list, but before he was the nominee.
That's correct.
So the idea that she's at the last minute trying to spike his confirmation, that seems to fly in the face of that. If she came forward with her story, or a version of her story, to the Post before he was even nominated. Number two, Dianne Feinstein did not tell anyone about this letter, didn't go to the chairman of the committee, didn't go to other Democrats. Was that at the behest of Ford? Did she want this to remain private, just in the senator's hands?
She did. She asked very clearly that the letter be kept confidential. And, her lawyer said to me in my story that they felt Feinstein really did right by Dr. Ford and preserved her privacy and honored her request for confidentiality.
There's not contemporaneous accounts of this, right? Ford did not tell anyone at the time that this happened, but in couples therapy, there's notes from couples therapy in 2012, and also apparently in a conversation with an individual therapist in 2013. Is this information that Ford and Katz together presented to you, or is this something you went and got from these two therapists?
Now, these are records that Ford got from her therapist and gave to her lawyer, who then showed them to me. The 2012 is the first time Christine Ford says that she told this story in any detail, and she did that during couples therapy with her husband. Her husband very clearly recalls this conversation. He recalls his wife using Kavanaugh's name and even voicing some concern that he might someday rise to the Supreme Court. His name does not appear in the records, so let's be clear about that. But there is, the records do reference an attack by boys from an elitist private, a boys' school, and who went on to become high-ranking members of society in Washington.
All right. There are reports this morning that supporters of Kavanaugh and Republicans in Congress are going to try to call for Ford to testify publicly, come forward in public, betting, perhaps, obviously, over her reticence over the last several months about going public, that she will decline. Do you think, based on your conversations with her, that she'd be willing to testify publicly about this?
I have not asked her that, and so I don't know the answer to that question. I do think it is, you know, coming forward in our newspaper was a huge and terrifying step for her, and I think that coming forward to be questioned publicly would be, you know, yet another huge and terrifying step.
Emma Brown, again, thank you for your reporting on this. You've been working on the story for months, and it has changed before your eyes and before our eyes over the last week. So thank you.
Thank you.